Today on Making It Home, I'm going to show you how to make this cutting board with a Lichtenberg pattern using your CNC and not high voltage electricity. To save some time today in the video, I've already gone into the easel software and I've set up three different cutting board blanks or serving trays that we can get started with. I've already gone through and set the size of the piece of wood to the three different pieces that I have, so I know what areas I'll be working with. I set my serving tray up at 0-0 in the lower left corner and then let the excess go to the upper right. And so by doing this, I can just kind of go off 1-inch increments for spacing and layout purposes. Next, we import the SVG file of the lightning pattern. I do this by hitting the menu button on the left side of the screen and accessing the file on my computer. So when I import this, it comes in, a lot of times these aren't rotated the way you'd like them to be. So just use the grips and move the lightning pattern to where you'd like to have it placed on the cutting board. I'm a big fan of the layout of these kind of patterns where the lightning looks like it's moving from one corner of the serving tray to the opposite corner. So I'm going to rotate this lightning pattern in a way that it starts at the coordinate space of 1-1 and goes up to the right. So one of the things you can do if your lightning pattern is not filling up the serving tray very well, you can actually grab the grips on the sides of the box when you have your selection, and you can pull it left, right, and expand it in and out and basically distort the image a little bit to fill that area. Now, one of the things I'm doing is I'm trying to leave about an inch gap all the way around the serving tray so that once we do a chamfer or a roundover on the cutting board or serving tray, we're not getting too close to the lightning pattern. The serving tray is currently set up with two elements on the screen. One is the outline of the serving tray itself, and the other is the lightning pattern. So what we're going to do now is we're going to duplicate this page twice, and then we're going to pull those duplicate pages back so all three pages are identical and in a row on the screen. So then the first page I use as kind of the master layout, and then the second page, what I'll do is I'll delete the lightning pattern on one and the outline on the other so that we can do two separate carves, one for the lightning pattern and one for the cutout. The other thing we're going to do right now is on the cutout portion of the board, we're going to go into the shape tab and we're going to go to the bottom where we can do a corner radius. And I just selected a half inch for both of these. I don't want anything too large. I don't want to lose a large portion of the board, but I do want something that's just going to round the corners and make it a little more comfortable to use and not have a sharp edge to deal with. On the V carving bit, we want to make sure we're cutting to the right depth so we're not going too deep into the board just in case the lightning pattern is a little wide. And on the outline cut with the quarter inch down cutting bit, we just want to make sure that we're going through the depth of the board itself. And I'm also adding tabs so that the tabs will hold the piece in place when we cut all the way through the wood with the quarter inch bit. The lightning patterns that you're going to find in the file that you can download for this project vary in complexity. And so what you're going to find is for generating a preview or a simulation, that sometimes this can take a little while depending on the type of computer that you have. So after we simulate the project, you'll see that this actually carves fairly fast with only 14 minutes to do this lightning pattern. The second serving tray we're going to work on is what I'm calling tray number two with mixed wood. And this is going to be a single lightning bolt pattern as well, slightly different than the first one. Just like in the first serving tray, the first thing I do is I set up the dimensions of the wood piece that I'm going to carve based on the wood blank that I have. Just like before, we're going to go into the file import section and select SVG for the option, and then find the SVG file on our hard drive and select it. Once it loads, you can rotate and rescale based on the size of your serving tray, just like we did for the first one. Just like we did previously, we're going to duplicate this page twice. Then on the first duplicate page, we're going to remove the outline cut. And on the second duplicate page, we're going to remove the lightning pattern. This way, the first duplicate page cuts out the lightning pattern and the second one cuts the outline of the board. third serving tray is a combination of the first two. What we're going to do is we're going to copy both lightning patterns to the third version, and then we're going to make them look like they're coming from opposite corners towards each other. To copy the lightning pattern from one of the previous trays, just go to that page in the bottom of the screen. Once you're there, left click with your mouse to select it, and then right click and select copy or hit Control C. Then select the page you want to copy it to, which should be farther to the right. And once you're there, you can hit Control V to paste it in place, or you can right click and select paste from that menu. The next thing you need to do is just arrange the lightning patterns in a way that looks good to you. For me, I put one in the lower left and one in the upper right, and then I scaled and rotated these until they look good together. This can take a little bit of time, but just get it to a point you like and move on to carving. Just like we did with the other two boards, now we need to duplicate this page twice, and then we're going to take the first duplicate page and we're going to remove the outline cut and just leave it as the lightning patterns with the V-bit. The third page, or the second duplicate page, will just be the outline cut using a 1/4 inch down cutting bit. Just in case you don't like the first two lightning patterns that I used, I have included some other ones that I had available. Now, I do have to say that I haven't tried carving these myself, and a couple are fairly complicated, so they may take a while to render. To get started, I just needed to mill up the different species of wood I had for the serving trays. I used up some wood that I'd had for quite a few years, and I even used some walnut from my father's farm. For a single species cutting board, I used a big piece of curly maple. I had to use it for one of these boards as the grain pattern was just too beautiful to pass up. We have purple heart, padauk, cherry, osage orange, found a little bit of that left over, so I threw it in, some red heart, some walnut, some bubinga, and a little more red heart, which I have to cut in half because it's too tall right now. Now I just arranged the different pieces of wood until I liked the layout. I had enough wood to make 3 separate serving trays. Next, I just glued all the pieces of wood together in the same order. Once I had these to the right thickness, I just had to take these over to the table saw and cut the rough ends off. I started by carving the first lightning pattern into the single piece of curly maple. So I did get a little burning down in the bottom of these grooves with the 60 degree V-bit. It was a new bit, so I'm not sure why it burnt like that. I must have had my router set up too high a speed. After cutting the lightning pattern, it was time to change the bit and cut the outline of the tray. I used an oscillating tool to cut the tabs on the tray and cut it loose from the main board.
Yeah, I think it's looking good.
Next, it was time to cut the second serving tray with the CNC. For all of these, I use a 60 degree V-carving bit to cut the lightning patterns. The double lightning pattern for the third serving tray turned out really great. I gave all of the boards a good sanding to remove the fuzzy edge that is created along the outline of the lightning pattern. This will help give you a good clean edge with the epoxy. I sealed the serving tray and the lightning pattern cut into the board with a clear layer of epoxy to keep any pigment from bleeding into the wood grain and possibly discoloring the wood surface. For the first epoxy pour, I went with black diamond pigment, black onyx. This has a little bit of sparkle to it and adds a nice touch to the lightning pattern. For the maple serving tray, I went with Black Diamond Pigment's Deep Blue Sea. I thought this would be a really nice contrast between the lighter maple and the deep blue color. For the double lightning pattern, I went with the pure gold pigment. This one turned out to be really cool in person. Since you want to pour your epoxy slightly above the surface of the wood, you can take off the excess later by using a flattening bit in the CNC or by using a planer. Using the flattening bit can work great and be more accurate than the planer, but it can also take a little more time. I then ran this through the drum sander to take the last little bit of epoxy off of the surface of the serving tray. For the other two serving trays, I just ran these through my surface planer. Just remember to take shallow passes so you don't take too much of the surface off. Just like with the first serving tray, I ran the other two boards through the drum sander to take off the excess epoxy. For the edge treatment on the boards, I went with a chamfer on two of the boards and a roundover on the other one. The last thing to do before adding finish to the boards was to take a random orbit sander to the surfaces. I sanded down to 800 grit to make the epoxy nice and smooth, but I think you really only need to go to 400 grit. Next, it was time to add the finish. My favorite one for something like this is Odie's oil. It's incredibly easy to apply. You just wipe it on, wait 20 to 25 minutes, and then wipe off the excess. The last thing to add to the boards were the rubber feet to keep them from sliding around on the countertops. These also give the boards a little height and make them a little easier to pick up.
Thanks for watching the video tonight. I'm really happy with how these turned out. I wasn't quite sure if it'd turn out the way I had it in my head, but they actually did. Using the clear epoxy and a thin coat to seal up all the wood grain really helped with keeping any kind of pigment or dye bleeding into the wood grain. And I'm really happy with the fact that this double pattern turned out as good as it did. The gold epoxy looks really cool. And actually the thin layer of clear epoxy adds just kind of a little edge around the gold color. So it almost does look like it was burnt with electricity. Anyway, make sure you subscribe. I've got a bunch of great videos coming up that you're not going to want to miss. And you can always check out some of the older videos as well. Thanks a lot.